This is actually my first convention, so I've never done one before, so I wasn't sure about what to expect, but it's amazing people's positivity and people's just passion for films and passion for superhero films, and really lovely to meet people.
Fans were absolutely blown away by Infinity War. Can you talk a little bit about how you got involved in the project and your initial reaction when you were going to be a part of the Marvel family?
Yeah, that's a really good question. I have an American agent who sent me the details that it was an audition for them, and I sent off a tape. I filmed it in my house, and feeling very silly, dressed up as something resembling the character, and you feel very silly when you do it. But so you send it off, and I had to do a couple of tapes for them, and then they a few months later they said they liked what I did, so they'd like me to be involved. And so, you know, I was a fan of Marvel before, but what was great was getting the part was going back and seeing all the Marvel films and doing your research and going back to the comics and seeing the kind of history, the backstory of the character. So it was they were wonderful people to work for, actually, and a wonderful company of actors, and a staggering achievement on so many levels to get all those actors together and that story with those directors, with the Russo brothers, and they really look after you well, and they're just really great people. So I had a great time. Yeah.
Of course, the MCU has been building to this climax for years now. What for you makes Thanos the ultimate villain, and how did you feel to be playing one of his most devastatingly lethal children?
Well, I started to read a bit more about him through the comics, but I have to say that, I mean, he's an amazing villain as he is, but what Josh Brolin did with him, I just thought was, you know, his natural weight as an actor, he's perfect casting for that role, because he just brought humanity, funnily enough, to the part in Infinity War. Great humanity, and which is kind of strange and paradoxical in a villain, but I just thought he was incredible, and it was great to work with him because he's a real actor's actor. He's there for the work, and he's also got a great sense of humor and was very welcoming to me on set. I'd never done a film that big, so it was great to work with him closely, and he was such a generous man, a generous actor. So he's just a legend, really, you know.
You were going toe-to-toe with Earth's mightiest heroes, particularly Mr. Benedict Cumberbatch, Mr. Robert Downey Jr. Can you talk a little bit about what makes both of them such astonishing talents?
Yeah, I it's very funny because as an actor, you watch other actors and see how great they are. But sometimes it's not until you're up close with them that you realise where the depth of their skill and their talent. And in both cases, their level of focus in different ways, you know, Robert Downey Jr. is so free flow. He's so kind of instinctive, and his improvisation and his sense of play and his invention is just kind of mind blowing. And so my job with my scenes with him was just kind of keep pace, really, and some of the stuff he was coming out with. And with Benedict again, his level of detail and his pursuit of the truth in scenes. And because, you know, you talk about truth and actors seeking at the truth. I think that's what makes Marvel special. And I think what Joe Anthony did really in the direction with the actors was to make sure we were being as truthful as we could be, even in this kind of slightly operatic fantastical setting, and they're kind of bringing stuff down to a very fundamental level of objectives in scenes and relationships and characterization that was really helpful. But both of those guys, Benedict and Robert Downey Jr., both great professionals and very welcoming and generous and kind. So they were a joy to work with, and I was so thankful that I got to work with them both.
Stephanie Moore and Doctor Strange's battle is very much effects-driven. Can you talk about the challenges of that, and if there are any particularly funny moments on set in terms of the difference between what is spectacular on screen, what was perhaps a little more mundane in real life?
Well, the thing I found not hard but tricky to negotiate at the start was eye levels. So, you know, I'm playing a character who's 7 foot tall, and you're trying to make sure your eye line is the right place for different... So that could be a bit confusing. Also, the head cam, so you've got the camera. And so sometimes when your head removed, the camera would, like, the head cam would go... So you'd be still, you know, you get the head cam in your face, or you're trying not to smack people in the face with your camera. And so, Yeah, but it was technical to a degree, but again, at the same time, Joe and Anthony really kind of wanted you to play with it and try and bring truth to it and react to the given circumstances. And so it was technical on one level, but they really encouraged you to be as truthful and as playful as you could be in the scenes.
Such a different vocal performance from your own. Can you talk a little bit about where it came from and some of those lines that you most relish getting to say on screen?
Yeah, that's a really good question. I think because he has a level of... There's something quite... what's the word? He's quite... He's almost like a preacher. He's a Thanos fundamentalist, I suppose, in a way. He's like a total believer. And so his oration... And his ability to use language to manipulate is like some great preacher, I think. And so I needed to find a voice that had a quality that could be declamatory in one way without being hopefully too hammy. And so it was mixing that kind of preacher-like and kind of PR spin-type, press officer-type character and his ability to talk in public. So that's where it came from. But then, you know, it's funny with actors, you know, sometimes you start to speak in a certain voice and you don't really know where it comes from, but it fits on some level. And obviously it's going in your head in some way and it just comes out and you're like, oh, okay, that's the voice. So that's kind of what it was, really, and it seemed to fit. So that was good.
When you meet fans, how often do they ask you to tell them that they are, even in death, children of Thanos?
Not yet too many, only a couple, so I'm sure there'll be a bit more, but I'm happy to do it. I just have to brush up on it a bit. It's been a bit rusty. It's been about a year, so I'll have to brush up on that one.
What was your reaction when you saw the finished film? Obviously, fans had a very strong reaction, particularly to those final scenes.
You're not told anything, and thankfully so, because you don't want to be the one to give away anything. And so I was glad of being ignorant of what was going on. I was as blown away by anyone. I went with my son, who's 7. So he was really, you know, he thought it was really cool. But I had no idea what was coming at the end. So it was as shock to me as anyone. And I just think their handling of it, real integrity and real kind of, it was such a classy, complex, strange ending. And not giving you what you thought you would get and leaving lots of questions open, and I think it took great courage to end in that way and to do what he did, what they did and what Thanos did, and I think it's paid off in the reception of the whole film.
Given the opportunity, oh, yes. Would you like to continue to play the character if that became possible again?
Yeah, I think it's he's a great character and fun to play, and I think it's a brilliantly written character. Some of the language and the dialogue that I got to say was just, you know, so much fun. Those parts are kind of gifts to actors. And also the physicality, and he's a very playful character. And it was wonderful to do. And given the opportunity, I'd love to revisit if possible, yeah. I just think, look out for the next one, Avengers 4, and I hope they enjoy it. And I hope their fears and dreams and all that stuff are answered. So I hope they enjoy it.